You talked about technology. AI will shape healthcare in the future. Are you investing in AI?
And we have made some early collaborations whereby we're hoping to develop, you know, there's two or three ways where AI could play a role. One is predicting, for example, the new mutant variant strains, whether it's for flu, whether it's for COVID, whatever else. Imagine instead of chasing, you can predict it. And therefore, you'd be able to have a vaccine or a medication ahead of the curve. Yeah. The other area is, of course, to bring down the cost and time for clinical trials. Now, this is huge. Imagine a pharmaceutical company spending $2 or $3 billion and that becomes a fraction of the cost and time, you know, instead of 6-7 years of trying different combinations, what works, what doesn't work. If AI can do that on a quantum computer or on a quantum scale or whatever, instead of doing it in humans, you're going to see a complete transformation and leapfrogging in the pharmaceutical and vaccine industry. Of course, we're probably 5 or 10 years away from that. Having said that, the only challenge there is that getting a regulator of a country to approve and agree that your AI model and this stuff you've done on the computer that you've predicted is working, but proving that somehow in a human model, animal model, that it's safe and it's working, instead of doing the actual human trials itself. Now, I don't know how that's going to work, but unless regulators agree and approve that process, you can't really end up using the AI tools that we have today. So that itself will be the only challenge. So probably, you know, I don't know, the US FDA or the EMEA, someone like that would have to take the lead in that, and then other country regulators may adopt those kind of standards. So there'll have to be some sort of AI-regulated standard that everyone will have to adhere to.